they think they can come here and they can buy the church, the religion and God. The BJP comes here and they offer crores of rupees to the church. Now you think about it. Just because they think that they can buy some MLAs or they can form the government in Goa by buying a couple of people or they can form the government in Manipur by buying a couple of MLAs, maybe they can even buy a couple of Congress MLAs in Meghalaya. But they have the arrogance to believe that they can actually buy the church. You just imagine that. That they think they can come here and they can buy the church, the religion and God. They have a lot of money. There's no shortage. You can see Mr. Narendra Modi talks of corruption. Day in, day out, he talks of corruption. But he doesn't answer the question, where does all the money that the BJP spends in their campaigns come from? Where does it come from? Where is it coming from? It certainly isn't coming happily from the people. Our opponents, the BJP, feel that Meghalaya is part of India. That is their approach. In a sense, you belong to us. That is not my approach. My approach is, if Meghalaya is India, then India is also Meghalaya. And we believe in your ideas. We want your ideas to be heard, not only in the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, but in every corner of India, because we believe that it is with your ideas and millions of other ideas like yours that the country can move forward. And I consider Meghalaya to be a central part of the Indian idea.